dominance of life never in one place still ran in my deepest blood. Or so I was told. No one was still alive that had set foot in one of the fabled bruises our people used to make, or that had gazed on stars from out of a body unchained by home gravity. And that was the part they rarely tell you about. Space travel operates on more than just three axes. Most of the journey, at least as far as the eye could tell, was through time. You stepped onto a ship and away from your life. That first step was the door hummed to a close behind you. That first step was a lifetime. I am a lantern awash in a storm, and he is flotsam that I found within the stream. How can I hold on to him when he is adrift just as I am, when he has nothing to hold on to himself? Humanity is a chain. It is one tissue which feeds itself, extremities upon extremities that somehow, in the midst of groping hunger, feed each other. And space travel was sold to us, the people of Episcopal, and a million other planets, like it was the great savior, the great release from the prison of community, the soldier's knife that would incise into the common flesh and free the individual suffering. But to me, it is no such thing. This is space for me. An impossible ocean that separates me from the life I knew. A life I had thrown away, thinking it was too small. The irony is that at least the sailor on an endless ocean knows she has a goal, a beacon, a place to return to. I don't have even that. But if I'm truly honest, and on this, the eve of my arrival, I would like to be, I was always lost. Lost life, it wasn't that it was too small, it was that it was too big. And we dreamed, oh how we dreamed, and in dreaming we wounded ourselves every time we woke up to gaze on our bluish sun. A people of fools, of faint-hearted saps, wilting in wax towers. Oh, so it seems to me now. But when I was there, still a child, the memories were the sweet taste of drinking honey, the faint buzz of a stomach that had gorged itself. Until the ships came, the beautiful blue moon and sky ships. I thought I could escape my hunger. But nothing makes you more hungry than the stars. Now, the ship had decelerated enough so that I could make out individual stars out there in the ocean. An ocean filled with stars, a deep heart for me to fill with starlight. The hunger is stronger than ever. The body beside me shifts and it has red hair, impossibly beautiful hair. In the corner of the room, I can hear my father's hushed whispers as he speaks of the monosaurs of the late crusaders. The wish-wish sound of my mother's brush is his beat as she paints a purple scene of coronation. Thus, the cliché is all too real. The hunger was inside me. Forget the human tapestry. Forget the organism which has no end, the body we call humanity. We are endless continuity, fragile repositories of liquid memory, songs, hope, fear, and most of all, longing. A longing for a home that isn't there anymore. A longing for a home that once was, but is now separated from us by an empty ocean. A longing for a home that we carry with us, and are thus incessantly reminded of its absence. Body wakes. My eyes open. I am alone. 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 alone.